she plays that, just that beautiful anointing music. As I said, just we need restoration, a lot of us, physically, even emotionally drained. Just let that anointed music wash over you. I feel that right now in the Spirit. Just wash over you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Let it just wash over you. Let the worries of the week, let the troubles and trials that are part of life in a fallen world that is just washed away, let the Lord just take it all. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Out of your mind, but Him. Oh, thank you. That just, you're so beautiful, Lord. Nothing but you. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Mm. Just focus on Jesus, and while you do, just know that whatever you need, He's right there with it, ready for you. Just receive it. Lord, you need physical healing? Receive it right now. For whatever it is, just receive it right now. Hallelujah. Oh, God. Jesus. You need emotional healing? Just receive it right now. Our focus. I'm praying enough. We got to pray more, people of God. It's alright to go down the road and pray, that's good. It's alright to be brushing your teeth, praying on the way to work or school or wherever, that's good. Keep doing it. But there's got to come a time you draw aside. I feel that. Oh, Holy Ghost, thank you. It's got to be a time you draw aside. Go into your prayer chamber, go into your war room. You have to put on some anointed music to get you in the flow because you may not feel like it. You may have a lot of stuff to do. Oh, you got so much to do, you're thinking. Well, that's the most important thing you got to do is shut yourself away a little while each day. If all you got is 10 minutes, it's worth it. Shut yourself away. Play a song on your iPhone or your computer or whatever and just get into His presence. And if you don't feel like it, I promise you that music can help usher you into His presence. That minstrel's anointing. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Lord, make me a house of prayer. Make me, Lord, a house of prayer. May the fire on my altar never go out. Never. Day and night. Night and day. Make me a house of prayer, God. Day and night. Night and day. Hallelujah. Make me a house of prayer. Jesus. If we all pledge it right now, if you can see all these individual houses of prayer right now in this bigger house of prayer, what a firepower we would have if we were all in His presence in prayer and in fasting and in study of His Word the way we need to be. I'm talking to myself most of all. If we were all doing that fervently, I mean fervently, you just imagine the firepower that would go forth everywhere we went. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Jesus, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for that new song. I've been singing that song along with Eddie James for the last 3-4 months. Now we know that we can sing it too. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Just sing it, Chelsea. We'll follow you as best we know it.
Hear the word roaring with thunder, with a new future to tell.
Hallelujah.
For the dry season is over, there is a cloud. Hear the word roaring as thunder, with a new future to tell. For the dry season is over, there is a cloud beginning to swell.
Go on further.
To the skies heavy with blessings, lift your eyes, offer your heart. Jesus Christ, open the heavens. Now we receive the Spirit of God.
Jesus,
we receive your name.
Will y'all just receive it while we sing it? Hallelujah, hallelujah.
We receive your name.
Hallelujah, 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 Jesus.
Every seed buried in sorrow, you will call forth in its time. You are Lord, Lord of the harvest, calling our to arise. We receive your rain.
Jesus, I receive your rain, Lord. I receive, oh God,
Even imagine.
strength to do what you thought maybe in the flesh you couldn't do. But in Him and in that cloud of His condensation, His rain, you can do it because it's not you anyway. Because He is able, we are able. Because He is first through us, then we are. Yes, there's abundance in her cloud. I see that. I receive, y'all ought to just receive that along with her. I receive that abundance in that cloud. Ooh. Oh, I'm seeing it so much. It's moving me, this strength and this abundance in the cloud. I see Him providing all the strength we need to persevere to get it done. And I see the abundance. Oh, I see that. Abundance. Whew. Coming in for everything we need. Because God, we can't do it, but because You are able, we are able to carry it out. I hear the sound of abundance of rain. What I feel in here right now, I need it, people of God. I need it. And what I feel in here right now, I want for everybody in the world. Everybody in Walnut Cove passing down the road this morning, I'm praying it emanates to them. That they can feel it in their cars. Hallelujah. Everybody that walked by our booth yesterday, whether they stopped by and took a t-shirt or a flyer, whatever, I want them all to feel this. Because I think if they did, they would never be satisfied till they had the fullness of Him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Here's what I feel right now. I'm moved, people of God. His Spirit is so beautiful this morning. He gives us everything we need. I think we need it such a sweet, refreshing, rainy day such as this. And I feel as if there are testimonies in this room that's got to come out. I always ask for testimonies, but it's different today. There's, I don't know, there's stuff in this room. Somebody needs to tell. Say it, Lige.
Have a testimony that just shows how God works and how good He is. We, after a ball game, it was maybe Thursday. And it was Chelsea. Yeah, it was on Chelsea's birthday, and she'd come to see us play. And it had been a rough game in general. We had lost, and I had not played well. It just wasn't good. And I was frustrated and down. Anyways, we went to go eat at a restaurant, and it was late, so we went to like the only one we really could. And when we went, there was a waiter there. He was really nice, and he was really, really good. And I just felt, you know, from God to give him, you know, a lot of money. I mean, a lot of money for just a moment. Yeah, necessarily. But, and then, you know, and I wrote a little note, you know, to hopefully to bless him. But anyways, and I just, you know, I didn't think anything else of it, but I went home, and the next day I had dance rehearsal. It was a busy day, and after dance rehearsal, I had some of the people tell me that I should go out to eat with them, and so I did. And that heard the check, you know, the waitress was coming around asking how to split up the check, and I was like, oh, I'm by myself. And she said, no, that he already paid for your food. And so he paid for my food. And then the next day, yesterday, I went to eat after recital with a bunch of people from recital. And the waitress came over and said, how are the checks going? And I said, I'm by myself. And then somebody went, no, I've got yours. And so they paid for my food. But then not only that, I got a card from someone. And in the card was a really kind note and money that was almost exactly three times what I had paid in tip that to that waiter. And that blessed me so much, because I wasn't giving to receive, but it just shows you that when you do give, and you might be thinking, oh, like, you know, gosh, that's like all I got in my wallet. That's good.
Yeah, he took out all he had in his wallet.
Yeah, when you don't have a ton of money, you kind of think to yourself, should I do this? But when you follow God, He does bless you. Because in the next 2 days, I didn't have to pay for a meal at the restaurants we went to, and I got blessed, very blessed with
unexpectedly.
Money. Yeah, and so it just, He is just so good.
He is.
There's no other way to say it.
You know, it's almost, I don't want to say overused, but we've heard for so long you can't outgive God. But it's true. I mean, how you can't. And my children teach me lessons every day. Because when I saw the money he put out on that table, and I love that waiter. He was a rough sort. You can tell, but that doesn't matter. You love people no matter what. I don't know that he knows the Lord, but I want him to. Elijah left him a note about the well. And when Elijah put the money out on the table, I can't remember what I said. Did I say, how much is that? Or, you know, I raised an eyebrow sort of like, did you leave? And then Chelsea and Elijah were like, it doesn't matter. I mean, Alan and I tip good. We always tip 20% or more he tips, because he pays. But, I mean, this was like, what am I thinking? If that child wants to empty out his wallet and put that on the table, then hallelujah. I should have been rejoicing. And I was. Once I thought about it, I'm like, Leslie, that's awesome what he did for that guy. And I found that boy on Facebook. We ain't done with him yet. I found that waiter.
Well, he spent the whole time when he was telling us stories, because we got there late before they were closing, and he was telling us all these stories about people who don't believe in tipping, and just all these crazy stories of people who had been so rude to him. And so I thought, you know, what a testimony it was, what Elijah did, you know, that he looks and sees, well, those people are different. That is something that is going to stick with him.
Right. Because I want to just tell you this flat out. People who work in the restaurant business will tell you that some of the worst tippers in the world are the Christian people that come after church. Nobody wants to work on Sundays because the Christians who come in after church are the worst tippers. Some of them will even leave little flyers. You don't know it's a flyer because it looks, it's disguised as a $10. Is it $10 bill?
Yeah.
Looks like a $10 bill. And they'll slide it under the plate so that when the waitress comes, I got a $10 tip, and you take it out, it's not money, it's a tract telling them I need to get right with the Lord. Yeah, really?
And it says that an older it says it's better to give than receive. I've seen some of them say. Talking about receiving Christ.
Yeah, it's better to. Yeah,
better to give, and you know, and that's why they don't need the tip.
So that's a bad testimony on the body of Christ. but not here. I know that. So that's the kind of testimony I'm talking about. Who else has got one? I think you need to tell something else about what happened to you Thursday morning, if you're all right with that.
Well, I was, you know, getting ready to go to a nursing home, and sitting in the car, and just finished my devotions and sitting there. And, you know, I had plenty of time, and just as if the Lord spoke to me and said, leave right now. Go as quickly as you can. I won't go help
you. You don't go there first. No. She goes to Walnut Ridge first, not the health care. But God said go to health care.
And I did. I heard probably even Sped coming over here. Sped. But anyway, when I went in and went down the hall where my sister-in-law, she's my sister-in-law for 38 years.
We prayed for her.
When I started down the hall, her daughter came back. Her daughter was there by herself. Her son had spent the night with her, but he had already gone home, and Allison, a maid we called, was there, and she saw me, and she started just crying out, Jude, she said, Mama's not breathing. Mama's quit breathing. You've come just right at the right time. She said, I'm here by myself. And I said, Nay, you know, the Lord sent me right now. I said, that's why I came. The Lord sent me right now. And I stepped into the room, she and I did. And she had called the two nurses in there, you know. Every little bit she'd say, Nay, she breathed. And I said, yes, she took two breaths. And after I was beside the bed, I went to the bottom of her bed and put my hands on her feet. Of course, they were already cold. She was dying. And started praying. And then they said, Judy, just pray out loud. Pray out loud. And I started praying, and those nurses just, you know, started just hugging, and anyway, I saw her take her last breath, and I made it very plain in that room that she had gone to be with Jesus, trying to give comfort, you know, and I was thinking that is the fourth person of someone loved, Mr. Gray, mother, Joe, August husband, my brother-in-law, and now Adamant, that when I just happened to be there, and they took their last breath. And I felt so privileged. I'm telling you, I felt privileged. And I told him, I said, I'm so thankful that I could help usher her into heaven. And it just brought such peace. And I walked out of that room, and I thought, you know, I could go home, and I could just cry at home. Or else I could go to the nursing home and try to bless people.
Yes.
And that's what I did. And when I told them at assisted living, and I was, you know, a little bit late getting in there, but when I told them, I said, you know, I could have gone home, and I told them what had happened, because a lot of them knew how to do. And I said, but I wanted to come here and be with y'all. And it touched me.
You know it did.
One man said, oh, I can't believe this. I said, thank you, thank you. And I said, no, don't thank me. Y'all are blessing me. They lifted me up.
Mm-hmm.
God is so good, I cannot tell you. When you know that someone has gone to be with the Lord,
hallelujah.
You rejoice.
Hallelujah.
You rejoice in that.
Oh, thank you, Lord.
God is so good.
Thank you, Lord.
And you were talking about, you know, Elijah was talking about healing. Y'all remember the little boy who came by the booth yesterday where we were, and he had already been one time, he came back and he said, y'all were so awesome. That was his, y'all are so awesome. He said, y'all are giving away free things. Y'all are giving away free things. That made my day.
I just made my day. The same old boy that kept coming back. After you left, he kept coming back. He was just so happy to come to that booth. And finally, I think he might be the one we said, take a handful. I don't know. We told somebody, take a handful of candy.
He gave him water and said it was the best water there.
This is the best water there. And I just sort of went, that's town water. Well, okay. There you go. Anointed.
Ooh. He'll never forget that.
No, he won't.
He's not the only one, too. There were several other kids that made the comments that we were the only ones to make things for free.
Yeah, and we were trying to not give away stuff people were selling. You know, because we didn't want vendors upset with us. We were just giving away a little candy and water. And First Christian was giving away water, too. So there was two churches in town giving away water. favor of God follows you. The favor of God follows you. You know what I feel about you people? You are an obedient people. Well, I'm not praying the way I should, Leslie. I'm not reading the Bible. You're obedient people. Now, yeah, pray more. I'm telling you and me too. Read the Bible more. But you are obedient, and obedience brings blessing. Disobedience does not produce. God spoke that to me years ago. Disobedience does not produce. Obedience does produce, and it brings blessing. You are an obedient people, and as an obedient people, the favor of God rests heavily upon you. Heavily. The favor of God. Oh, I receive that, Lord. Your favor. Yeah, you live in a fallen world. It doesn't mean everything goes right. Fallen world and fleshly people all around you. And sometimes we let the flesh override, don't we? The favor of God is upon us. The anointing of God is upon you. And wherever you go forth with favor. Ooh, Jesus, hallelujah. I hear that sound, Lord, of an abundance of rain. We want to take your love out to the world, God, to the people of this world. These 13 people, Lord, we want to change the world for you. Turn it upside down. You can do it. You can do it. You're going to run into people this week that need you.
Do it one by one.
And even with random acts of kindness, one by one. And that's why when I saw my cloud, oh, I feel that strength and abundance that we saw in the clouds. I see him doing everything we need to do, and it's all right there ready for us. The cloud is on the horizon. The cloud is right there, and that's why I want to read this scripture. I have here this anointed scripture. Who's got? Who found? Anybody? It's, they finished the battle on Mount Carmel, remembering King Ahab, and there's been no rain for 3 years. Or is it 3.5? 3 to 3.5 years there's been no rain. And all of a sudden, is it Elisha or Elijah?
Elijah
tells his servant, go look. Go see if you see anything. Nope, don't see anything. Go back again. That sounds about right.
And he said to his servant, go up.
Yes.
Look towards his. There is nothing, and he said, go again 7 times. And it came to pass at the 7th time that he said, behold, there arises a little cloud out of the sea like a man's hand. And he said, go up, say unto Ahab, prepare thy chariot and get thee down. The rain stop thee not.
What's after that? Where does Elijah run?
46.
What does he tell me that one?
And the hand of the Lord was on Elijah, and he girded up his loins and ran before Ahab to the entrance of Jezreel.
Which was quite a distance. As soon as we came in this morning and I felt what I felt, I started thinking about a memorial, building a memorial, something that's going to last. And then we sang the song about the cloud, and I'm asking you, what do you see in your cloud? You're going to have to see that. You're going to have to see it. Because the first time, oh Jesus, the first time that Elijah told his servant, go look, he saw nothing. He saw absolutely nothing, but Elijah knew that rain was coming. Why? Because God told Elijah, you have the power to shut up heaven or to release the rain. And you can pray that there be no rain, and there'll be no rain. So there had been no rain. The heavens had been shut up for all those years. And then all of a sudden Elijah knew it was time for the rain. But at first glance, it didn't look like there was going to be any. A lot of preachers preached that he went 7 times. That the servant went 7 times. I disagree. I think he went 8. Now, it's not a big deal to argue over that, but the number 8 means new beginning. Now, seven is a great number too. We know that. But eight biblically is a new beginning. Because he told the servant, go look. The servant goes and says, there's nothing. Comes back. And it says, and Elijah sent him back seven times. So if he sent him back seven times, I personally think the servant went, eight times. New beginnings. And when he went the eighth time, he said, I see something, but it's just like this little cloud the size of a man's hand I'm looking at. And that's when Elijah said, go tell Ahab. Y'all get ready, get ready, get ready. I'm paraphrasing that. Get ready, get ready, get ready. Because I hear the sound of abundance of rain. He didn't say an abundance or the abundance. He just said plain old abundance. I hear the sound of abundance of rain. Do you understand what he did first? They saw the cloud. No rain coming out. But Elijah could hear the sound. That song we were talking about the other night. I hear the sound of
the 40s. Verse.
Do you hear the sound? I hear the sound of abundance.
And he told the king that before he went and told the servant to look. He told the king to get up and eat and drink.
Because the rain's coming.
He said, Elijah said unto Ahab, get thee up, eat and drink. For there is a sound of abundance of rain.
Before he saw the cloud, he was speaking it already. I hear the sound of abundance of rain. Eight times. Going to look, and then all of a sudden there's the cloud. And Elijah girded up his loins and took off running. I can just see him in the spirit, just taking off running. I forget how far that is, but it's quite a ways that he ran. Did he make it to the palace before the king? I can't remember. Almost seems like he got there before the king with his chariots and stuff. Elijah, by the Spirit of God. And then there came the rain. I feel like there's coming a rain in this town. It's coming all over the world. But here we are in this little town right now. And it's going to drench. Absolutely drench. We've seen it. We've seen the visions of pent-up waters just about to burst and leaking down. We've seen the overflow getting ready to come. Like you just can't hold it. Can't you just see it like my hand's shaking? Like you just... And then there it comes all of a sudden. I hear that sound. Sometimes you got to hear something before you even see it. You got to hear it. It's coming. We are going to change the world. Did you hear me? We are going to change the world. Because as he is able, so are you to change the world. Maybe all you're going to do is you're going to change it at the hospital up there when you go volunteer. That ain't all you're going to do. But I'm saying even if that was all you're going to do, or all maybe if all she was going to do was random acts of kindness, but that's not all you're going to do. Maybe it's, I don't know what you're doing where you are.
I hear that song, The Days of Elijah.
These are the days of Elijah. Megan's not a favorite song, but I love it. Hallelujah. I hear the sound of abundance of rain.